if we need to write off a particular invoice that we know is uncollectible, we can certainly do that. And the easiest way to do that, if we wanted to write off this particular invoice here, quickest way to do it is to select the invoice you want to write off. So what we're going to do is we create a new sale. Essentially, it's going to be a negative sale. And we will use the same customer, Caroline Industries. And we don't want to turn a quote into an invoice, so we're going to skip this screen here just by canceling. We're going to type in a particular invoice number here we want to write. We may put in WO for write-off. And here we're going to put in a PO number if we have to, but this is essentially going to be a credit memo with whatever date we need. And you can put a little note in here. The account we want to use in this case to write off to is going to be bad debt expense. And the amount is going to be a negative amount. Essentially will be a credit. The system will recognize as a credit to be applied against the original invoice. So what do we have now? We have a description. We have the customer. We have an invoice number, whatever invoice number you choose to put in here. You could put CR and then the original invoice number if you like. Some people do that. Lets them know that it is a credit. Down below here, it shows our subtotal, -$250. Certainly, we would want to put in any taxable amount here that we may have invoiced originally. And it shows our total amount of -$250. Nothing paid today. This is not a cash receipt, so we don't have to worry about that. Payment method is, you don't really need to put anything in here necessarily, although you could if you want to, but we're not really receiving cash. And this will tell you over here, sale, Carolina Industries. What I quite frequently will do, will take this sale, and I will change this to write-off for the journal memo. And I'm probably not going to print this, so I will say already printed or sent there. It won't sit in the queue of invoices to be printed. And if I needed to, in this case, put a category in there, I certainly could. We're not required right now to, but I would fill that out just as a normal invoice. And I would hit record. And I would cancel here. Get back into my sales register area. Now when I go to returns and credits, I'm going to see that -$250 amount here. But I want to apply that to the sale. And what that will do is it will take the sale and the credit memo off the accounts receivable aging. When I apply this to a sale here, it's going to essentially take that credit amount of $250 and apply it wherever I like. So I'll just apply $250 against this particular invoice here. And then I'm out of balance by zero amount, so that's correct. I'll go ahead and record that. Close. I'm back in the sales register again here. I can actually see that credit memo for this particular Carolina Industries. I can see it being applied. If I wanted to drill down a little further, I can see where that was applied against. Okay. Going into the history, I can say, okay, this particular sales journal number 3 is your original amount. I applied $250 against that particular invoice. And then I'm good to go. What that effectively did was it got it off my aging. What else can we do in the sales register? Like I mentioned, we went through it earlier. We can turn a quote into an invoice at this point, or you can do it in the details section as well. Down below here, turn it to an invoice. Keep in mind, too, that for any of these transactions in the sales or any other module, you can save as a recurring transaction. So you don't have to keep entering the same information in every month or a particular information for a client, a customer. You don't have to keep doing that. Let's see a list of open invoices for this particular client. If you didn't want that customer, you could open all customers and see all of your invoices. Returns and credits for all of them as well. Now this one here may not have been applied to a particular sale, so it's going to sit on your aging as a credit amount. And it may in fact sit there until you have a new sale or a new invoice created, and then if you need to apply it against that invoice, you can use the same procedure. Just come down below and apply that to a new sale that you entered in. And of course you can see all your old ones. If you drill down to one of these, you can also reprint an invoice from this section as well.